And here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of French lottery operator FDJ after it confirmed it would acquire Swedish gambling company Kindred for $2.7 billion. The stock surged 8% on the news. Also in focus, shares of embattled plane maker Boeing after the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration recommended that all airlines operating the 737 should get them inspected after the Alaska Airlines incident. Boeing shares are down over 2% in the pre-market. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Sony, which scrapped plans for a $10 billion merger of its Indian unit with Zee Entertainment. New York-listed shares of the Japanese conglomerate are up 1%. It closed nearly 2% higher in Japan. Asian markets saw a mixed start of the week. Chinese shares led declines after the People's Bank of China left its loan prime rates unchanged. The Hong Kong Hang Seng tumbled 2.3%, rather, dragged by real estate stocks. Japan's Nikkei 225, meanwhile, rallied to a fresh 34-year peak, with all sectors seeing gains. Here at home, Philippine shares also outperformed, with the main index rising 1.2%.
Surely hope that 6.4 and 6.5 will hold. Should it go lower, we would still be more aggressive in positioning. We are more optimistic from last year. It would be it would kind of be too advanced to reach the 7,000 level and sustain it if we're not going to go on data-driven news. Market right now is actually started correcting last week, but then it's kind of rebounding from that correction, and so it's putting a pause on expectations that we were going to buy on dip. But all the same, I insist on managing your portfolio, having your set support targets and waiting there, because I think sustainability of rally might be a little bit more in question today after having rallied quite generously from late last year.
Have this just in, the resolution seeking to amend the economic provisions of the Philippine Constitution formally raised to a Senate panel for review. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri filed resolution of both houses, number 6, last week after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. directed the upper chamber to take the lead in reviewing the economic provisions of the Constitution. Senators held a caucus today, Monday, on the matter, leading to the resolution being sent to the Senate Committee on Constitutional Amendments and Revision of Codes, chaired by Senator Robin Padilla. The move comes amid a push for a people's initiative to amend the charter.